So today we are going to see about a topic that is called as a damped free vibration with the viscous damping. So now what is actually is the damped free vibration? First of all, we will look into the concept of the damp. What is meant by damped? Now, when any system oscillates or vibrates, and if you want to bring that system to a halt, means you have to apply some रेसिस्टेंस टू द मोशन ऑफ द ऑसिलेटिंग बॉडी. जो भी आपकी बॉडी ऑसिलेट हो रही है या वाइब्रेट हो रही है, इफ यू वॉन्ट टू स्लो डाउन, इफ यू वॉन्ट दैट बॉडी कम्स टू रेस्ट, देन यू हैव टू अप्लाई एन एक्सटर्नल रेसिस्टेंस. एंड दैट रेसिस्टेंस इज अप्लाइड बाय मीन्स ऑफ ए डिवाइस. दैट डिवाइस इज कॉल्ड एज ए डैम्पर. सो इफ आई से वॉट इज मीन बाय डैम्पिंग, द रेसिस्टेंस टू द मोशन ऑफ द ऑसिलेटिंग बॉडी इज नथिंग बट कॉल्ड एज ए डैम्पिंग. And the device that provides the damping is called as the damper. Now in our system, if there is no vacuum, just like if I am standing in a normal atmosphere or environment, the air plays a very important role. Whatever the damping is present, if this external damping is not present, the only damping that is present naturally is nothing but the air damping, air resistance, we can say that. Now, damped free vibration with viscous damping. We are taking into consideration the free vibration. As you have already studied what is the concept of free vibration, no external excitation is provided, and here no external resistance is provided, only the resistance is provided by the damper, which is a part of the system. Now viscous damping. Now there are various types of damping that we are going to study. Now viscous damping, we can say that it is in general, if I want to simplify that, the viscous damping comes under a category of the shock absorbers. We have some amount of a fluid that is having some amount of viscosity, and that prevents the oscillation of the body, or it absorbs the shock. Just like this example of your shock absorber, whether it is having a gas or whether it is having a fluid or an oil, that we can say relate that your shock absorber is a kind of a viscous damper. And second, another important type of damping that we are going to study is called as the Coulomb damping. And what is the meaning of the Coulomb damping? Coulomb means what? Dry friction. By means of friction between the two surfaces, the motion is retarded. Fine? Now, we have to first derive the generalized differential equation of the damp free vibration with the viscous damping. Now you can see that as we have already studied, the cases of the mass and the spring. Now here we are having a mass, we have a spring, and we have a damper, which is given by the symbol C. Now C is called as the damping coefficient. Just like the K is called as the spring constant, C is called as the damping coefficient. Just like the spring force is a function of displacement. We know F equals to Kx, spring force is a function of displacement. And when we are dealing or talking about the damper, now your damping force is a function of the velocity, F equals to Cx dot. This note it down, F equals to Cx dot is, or you can say as F equals to C into the velocity. So damping force is a function of velocity, and the spring force is a function of the displacement. Now this body is in the equilibrium condition. Now if you want this system to oscillate, we have to provide a force x in the downward direction. Fine, hume kya karna hai? X provide karna hai downward direction mein. Now if we see about the free body diagram of this system, we have displaced the system by a distance x in the downward direction. Fine, now what will be the forces acting on the system? Again we have to consider the D'Alembert's principle. Fine, so the displacement is in the downward direction. So as usual, our inertia force will be in the upward direction. And what is the value? It is mx double dot. Inertia force is in the upward direction. Similarly, spring is a kind of a restoring force, so it will try to bring the body to the mean position. We have a spring force which will acting in the upward direction, kx, because the spring will pull the body in the upward direction. And the same function is that of the damper. The body is displaced, this damper will also try to bring the body to the mean position, because the function of the damper is only to than the vibration. So it is also a kind of a restoring force. So it is given by formula Cx dot. Now what is the statement of the D'Alembert's principle? Submission of the inertia torque plus submission of the external torque is equals to what? Zero. So we will get inertia torque is nothing but mx double dot. What is the external torque? Sorry, external force kx plus cx dot equals to zero. Or if we can rearrange, we will get mx double dot plus cx dot plus kx equals to zero. Now you are seeing an equation. This is the second order differential equation. X double dot means what? D square x upon dt square plus c dx by dt plus kx equals to zero. So you have already studied in your mathematics. This is the second order differential equation, and for the second order differential equation, the solution is given as x equals to e raised to st. Okay, this is the solution of the second order differential equation. X equals to what? E raised to st. Now, what is s? S is nothing but s is a constant. S is what? Constant. And we are interested in determining the value of the constant. We have to find out the value of the s. So for time being, just look at your screen and what is present, so that for 2 to 3 seconds you can just look it down what is there in the screen, and after that we will proceed with the derivation. Kindly look out on the screen what is written. Just recall what is written here. Now we are back again. What is our main motto? We have to find the value of the s. Now how to find out the value of the s? Now I am rubbing it down. Now what is our equation? Mx double dot plus cx dot plus kx equals to zero. This we have got from the D'Alembert's principle. Fine. Now we are interested in getting the value of s, because x equals to e raised to st is the solution. So here what is required? X dot is required and x double dot is required. So we will differentiate. X dot will become what? S e raised to st by the formula of e raised to at of your differentiation. Similarly, x double dot will become s square e raised to st, and we are putting this value here. So what we will get as m s square e raised to st plus c s e raised to st plus k e raised to st equals to zero. Now e raised to st is common, so it will get nullified. So what you are getting? M s square plus c s plus k equals to zero. Fine. Now from this we can see that we are getting a quadratic equation. This is kind of a quadratic equation, and we have to find out the value of the roots. Now we can see here that my a equals to what? M. I can say my b is equals to this c, and my c is equals to this value of k, and I have to find out the value of s. As it is a root, we have two values, 1 and 2, for a quadratic equation. And what is the formula for that? Minus b plus or minus under root of b square minus 4ac upon 2a. Fine. This is the formula of finding the roots. Minus b plus or minus b square minus 4ac upon 2a. Now what is s? 1, 2 we will get minus b. What is the value of minus b? Minus c plus or minus b square. What is b square? C square minus 4ac, 4mk upon 2m. Okay, upon 2m. Now if we simplify this again, what we are getting S12 as minus C upon 2m plus or minus, we will take this inside the root, we will get C square upon 4m minus 4mk upon 4m square. We have taken the value inside. Fine. So if we subtract the values, we will get minus C by 2m plus or minus C by 4m. We can say C by 2m the whole square minus, here 4m and get cancelled, we get k by m. So as this is S1, 2, so if we take sign positive it will become S1, and if we take sign negative it will become S2. Fine. So what is the solution we will getting? We will be getting as x equals to e raised to s1t and x equals to e raised to s2t. Fine. And what is the general solution for that? We know that for this kind of equation we are having a general solution, that is nothing but x equals to a e raised to s1t plus b e raised to s2t. This is the value of the general solution. And what is a and b? A and b are the constant, and we have to substitute the value of s1 and s2, once it is taken as negative and another time it is taken as the positive. So fine, I think it is clear to everyone. So this is nothing but the general differential equation for a damped free vibration with viscous damping. You have to first put down the value of s1 and s2 from here. It will be minus C by 2m plus the value of under root minus C by 2m minus the value under root. And at S1 and S2, you have to substitute here as S1 and S2. I think this derivation is clear to everyone. Fine. And now just practice it and we will move further with the next part. Thank you.